الحمد لله وكفى، والصلاة والسلام على نبيه المصطفى وعلى آله وصحبه ومن سار على نهجه مقتدى وعلى أثره اكتفى. All praise is due to Allah, whom we seek His help, we seek His forgiveness. We seek refuge in Allah from whatever evil our heart conceal and from the consequences of our evil deeds. Whomever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants guidance will never be led astray, and whoever He leads astray will never find guidance. And I bear witness that there is none worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who has no partners. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, His slave, servant and messenger. Respected brothers and sisters in Islam, the da'wah, or the status of da'wah, is the most highest status in Islam. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave this status to His messengers and the prophets. Not only that, Allah Almighty saying about Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Quran, قُلْ هَذِهِ سَبِيلِي, say this is my path. What is the path of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Is it the path of jihad? Is it the path of salah? Is it the path of Sadaqah? What is the real path of Rasulullah that Allah mentioned? He said, قُلْ هَذِهِ سَبِيلِي, say this is my path. أَدْعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ, I call people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. عَلَى بَصِيرَةٍ, with knowledge. And some of the ulama said, with wisdom. أَنَا وَمَنِ اتَّبَعَنِي, me and those who follow me. So the best thing that you can do, and the best thing that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did in his life, is what? He is calling people towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned there. Mentioned in the Quran. Not only that, Allah Almighty praises His messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and Allah Almighty praises those who are following the path of the Prophet Muhammad in da'wah. So He said, وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ قَوْلًا مِمَّنْ دَعَى إِلَى اللَّهِ, and who is better in speech than the one who invites people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا, and he does righteousness. وَقَالَ إِنَّنِي مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ, and then he will say, I'm among the Muslims. So the best person, the best job in the world is not to be the PhD doctor in the university, not to be the doctor in the hospital, not to be the engineer in the field. These are good jobs, these are really nice jobs. But the best job is the job that once you go and talk to the people and invite them to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I'll give you an example. All the prophets since the time of Adam alayhi salam till the last prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, all the prophets, when they came with different jobs. They used to do different things. Some of them farmer, some of them, you know, do another thing, some of them as a shepherd. But once they got the job of da'wah, they kept everything behind and they worked for da'wah. Yes, they kept everything behind. This is necessary. You have to do, you know, your work, your profession, whatsoever you're doing. But at the end, you give da'wah priority, number one. And I'll give you an example of Nuh alayhi salam. Nuh alayhi salam, he's talking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he's saying, Rabbi inni, O Allah, O my Rabb, O my Lord, I. What he said? I what? I prayed day night. I gave sadaqah day night. I build the masajid day night so people can worship you. No. He said, Inni da'awtu qawmi laylan wa nahara. I called people, I gave da'wah to my people, laylan wa nahara, day night. This is my task. This is it only. I only called my people day night. This is the da'wah that I was doing. And we all know for how long Nuh alayhi salam did da'wah. So this is what he's saying. Why he didn't pray day night? Why he didn't give sadaqah day night? Why he didn't do anything day night? Because he knew that da'wah is number one. Then what is good will come later on. But da'wah, you cannot leave da'wah. This is it. Not only that, our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you know, in seerah, if you read the biography of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in his whole life, he used to give da'wah to everyone. To his relatives, to his neighbors, to his companion, to his friends, even the one he will find in the street, he will give da'wah to him. Subhanallah. Not only that, he is calling people to Allah, he is calling people to go to Jannah. In return, what he is getting? He's getting the most horrible attitude, the most horrible reaction, the most horrible, and you cannot even imagine the treatment that he is getting from these people. Everyone knows when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went from Mecca to Ta'if. Mecca to Ta'if is almost approximately 90 kilometers. Imagine yourself. Imagine yourself into walking from Ahmadi towards Kuwait City and then going back. Just imagine if you can do it. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did it for us. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did it for the da'wah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did it for this deen, Islam. He walked all the way from Mecca to Taif, almost 90 kilometers or more. He spent 10 days in Taif, calling the leaders of Taif, the tribe leaders, calling the big people of Taif, calling everyone that he sees in Taif. In return, what he get? What he got? You cannot even imagine. People are spitting on his face, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. People are pushing him. People are rejecting him. Into the extent that these leaders telling their children that go and stone that person, throw the stone upon that. And they start throwing the stone upon Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam until he start bleeding. Into that extent that his bleeding went all the way down to his feet. Into the extent that his sandals was stuck to his ankle because of the blood. What he did? What he did? Subhanallah, he's just calling people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the return that he's getting. Imagine yourself ka da'iyah. And imagine, I will imagine myself, and you imagine yourself as a da'iyah. Imagine if you are giving da'wah and a person comes and slaps you. If you are giving da'wah and a person comes and spit on your face. If you are giving da'wah and a person comes and pushes you. If you are giving da'wah and a person comes and rejects you. What you will do? Leave all that. Into today's time, if you are going giving da'wah, and a person comes and criticizes you, and if a person comes and argue with you, and if you find a little bit criticism from here and there, from your family, from your brothers or friends or whatsoever, this person will leave da'wah, subhanallah. Just because little few words, you are leaving da'wah. If a person trying to hurt you, he didn't hurt you, he's trying to hurt you, and he will say, khalas, I don't want da'wah anymore. Subhanallah. And he is our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. People are beating him and hitting him and doing a lot of bad things to him, and he's still doing da'wah. Where we are and where the Prophet ﷺ and the companion. How we can compare ourselves with these giants? So, what to do in this case? Just remember, brothers and sisters, with great responsibility, that's the responsibility of da'wah, with great responsibility, the reward is great. With great responsibility, the difficulty is great. With great responsibility, you will get huge amount of criticism. It doesn't matter. Just go ahead. It doesn't matter, wallahi, just go ahead. It's nothing, it's not even 1% of what the Sahaba and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam faced in their life. It's nothing. Not only that, then how should we react? We react as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam reacted at that time. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, after getting all this behavior and treatment from these people in Taif, he went. He is so sad. And he is walking. And he is bleeding, and he doesn't know where to go. On spot angel, one of the angels came. And he said salam to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he said, Ya Rasulullah, if you want, I will bring these two mountain and smash these people. So this angel is waiting for only one sign or signal from Rasulullah. He is waiting only for one word from Rasulullah. He is waiting only for one word, that is go and do it. But what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said? He said no. He said no. I hope that later on Allah will make their progeny those who worship Allah alone without associating any partner. Subhanallah. Look at the mercy of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. After beating and hitting and blood and all these things, he's saying don't smash them. I hope that Allah will make their generation, their progeny later on who worship Allah alone. Where we are from this mercy, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. The lesson that we can get from this mercy is very important for me and you as a du'at. The first lesson is if you give da'wah to people, and people are trying to treat you in a bad way, they are saying bad things to you, they are cursing you, they are calling you names, they are whatsoever they are doing to you, they are even trying to hurt you, what you do? What the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam did. Don't reply back. Don't reply back, not because you don't know how to reply or don't because you are a weak. No, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam got the best weapon. Not nuclear even. There is an angel for him and one word from Rasulullah, and he will just make the whole nation like a qawm ad. No one know about them. So, what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, even he can do it with the ability, he said don't do it. So it's advice for me and you, don't do it. If someone comes and argue with you and talk with you and treat you in a bad manner and whatsoever, don't. This is the character of a da'iyah. Don't. This is what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said. Not only that, the second lesson that it's very important for me and you, that What the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, look at his vision. Look at the strategy, what's so called nowadays, you know, strategic planning. Look what he saw for the next years. He said, don't do it because I hope Allah will make their progeny to worship Allah alone. Same advice for me and you. If someone is not listening to you, someone is giving you his back and moving, and someone is giving you hard time with you know, discussion, don't say that, okay, this is a dead case, I will not give him a da'wah anymore. He is always making fight, he is always like this, he is always like that. Never! What the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said? He kept hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Same thing for me and you. Keep hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that inshallah he will be Muslim one day. Inshallah Allah will guide him one day. Inshallah he, his progeny, all his family will be Muslim one day. They will be guided one day. Always look up. Always keep hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is what we learned from this hadith. And I would conclude with 2 points, and they are very important points. As a da'iyah. Number one point, and before the points, the nasiha, the advice that I would like to advise myself and you is what? That a da'iyah should be having a wisdom and sabr. Always ask Allah to give you wisdom and sabr. This is the quality. Now, the two situations. You have two situations. Number one, the situation is you are giving da'wah to the people. You are inviting them to Islam, or you are inviting them to Allah. Either they are Muslims or non-Muslims. If they accept your message, then alhamdulillah, you are the lucky person. You are the luckiest person. Because their salah, their dua, their Quran, every single word they will read from the Quran, their dua, everything from them, their progeny, their wife, their family, till the day of judgment will be in your account. Subhanallah. This is the da'iyah. This is the win-win case. So, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, if one man get guidance through you from Allah, then it's like better than you own the whole world and one, what's in it. It's like having the whole world in your hand. So, this is number one. It's a win-win case. Second one, if you give da'wah to people and they return, if they return back, if they don't bother, if they don't listen to you, and if they want to hurt you, and if they want to argue with you, what you will do? Just have sabr. Just have sabr. What you can do? Just have sabr and keep hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In this case, there are three things in Islam that Allah Almighty didn't mention the reward of these three things in the Quran, neither the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned it in the hadith. Three things only, the ulama mentioned. Number one is fasting. As we know, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith al-Qudsi that Allah says, "As-sawmu li," that the fasting is for me and I will give reward for it. So the reward we don't know. Why? Because the ulama said it's countless reward. It's huge reward. So we don't know, and it's not mentioned in the Quran. Neither the Sunnah. The second thing is pardoning. Forgiving people. If someone said something bad to you, if someone treated you badly, if someone at work, at your home, in your family, whatsoever, if anyone did something bad to you, I know it's difficult upon nafs to forgive. But if you forgive for the sake of Allah, Allah will give you reward that you cannot even imagine. This is called al-afu. And number three, this is the main important for me and all of you as a du'at, is the sabr. Yes, those who have sabr, number one, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, inna allaha ma'a sabirin. Allah with those who have patience. So have patience. Not only that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives the reward of those who have sabr bi ghayri hisab. Countless reward Allah will give you on the day of judgment. So this is the quality of da'iyah that every da'iyah should have in themselves. That's why the Prophet Ya'qub said, وَصَبْرٌ جَمِيلٌ. The sabr is jameel. So keep this sabr as a quality of one of the qualities of a da'iyah. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to open our eyes, and I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to open our heart and mind so we can follow the Quran and the hadith as it should. It should be followed. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us to give da'wah in a way that other people accept it. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He will bless us so we can convey the message of Islam to everyone. اللهم عز الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم عز الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم ذل الشرك والمشركين. اللهم عليك بالطغاة الظالمين. اللهم عليك بالطغاة الظالمين. اللهم عليك بالطغاة الظالمين. اللهم وفقنا. اللهم سدد رمينا، اللهم وفقنا يا ذا الجلال والكرام، اللهم ثبت أقدامنا، اللهم ثبت أقدامنا، اللهم ثبت أقدامنا، اللهم وفق كل داعية يخرج في الخارج لإعلاء كلمة لا إله إلا الله، اللهم وفق كل داعية يدعو في سبيلك لأجل كلمة لا إله إلا الله، اللهم وفقنا أجمعين يا ذا الجلال والإكرام، اللهم وفقنا يا رب العالمين، اللهم آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وادخلنا الجنة مع الأبرار يا قوي يا قهار، وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين، وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأقم الصلاة.